Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the 8th edition of Fig Arts Festival. Since 2013, Fig Arts Festival has been instrumental in celebrating Christian artists by creating a platform through which their God-given gifts and talents are discovered, developed, and deployed to the world for the glory of God and the extension of His kingdom. The festival offers a unique opportunity for the Christian artists to radiate God's glory through their gifts. This year's festival is happening online due to the restrictions imposed by the COVID-19 pandemic. The pandemic is still with us, so we urge you to follow all protocols laid out in your various nations. We believe the scourge will soon recede, and we will come together once again to celebrate what God has endowed us with. Now, sit back, relax, and enjoy this exhilarating virtual festival, driven by our delectable hosts. Welcome Minister Pell, all the way from the United Kingdom. From Harare, Zimbabwe, Masi. And from the City of Kings and Queens, Gotutu Ziatunga, Kwablawayo. Let's welcome Kosi.
Since 2013, Fig Arts has been a place where we come to discover talent and gifts through music, dancing, poetry, you name it. Hi, and welcome to our virtual Fig Arts Festival 2021. I'm Minister Pell, and I'm going to be your host today. Sit back, relax, and enjoy. Don't forget to stay tuned and share this broadcast.
Indeed, the stage has been set, albeit virtual. Our artists and performers have been illuminating God to the world as they excel in their gifts and talents. Hi, my name is Masi, and it's a pleasant joy to be in your company today.
I hail from the city that defines African artistry, and trust me, even the scourge of COVID-19 cannot do us down. I am certainly ready for today's thrill as we bask in the amazing performances of our artists. I am Kosi, and to start off the show, we invite you to enjoy this musical item from one of the rising outfit from our ministry, Fig Worship Culture. Enjoy.
If
may not all be part of the fivefold ministry, but just as effective as those offices are in preaching the gospel of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, so shall our artists be as they scale the mountain of arts, media, and entertainment with a relevant message that will turn many hearts to their Maker.
And the Lord would say to you, Archbishop, everything is going to advance now. I see a training school you're going to develop. The training school will grow. It's going to be a training school for pastors, but also for musicianaries, the musicians. It's going to be a training school for, I see that includes dancers. And the Lord said, and painters and artists. The Lord said, I have given you many creative people, and I want them to paint for me. I want them to design for me. And the Lord said, many designers will come out of your church for clothing, architects. The Lord said, I'm going to bring the young university students, and they're going to come, and they're going to worship the Lord. You're going to be part of this Jesus people movement. The Lord says, I'm going to give you the anointing for what you're doing now. It's going to be so much greater. You're going to have everything you need. The Lord says, when I called you to do this, I gave you what you needed. I gave you the faith. I gave you the favor. I gave you the provision. Hallelujah! Let's clap our hands. Amen. Amen.
Tonight, allow me to welcome the visionary of this strategic ministry, our very own father, Archbishop Dr. Asa Gurupira, and invite him to share his heart with us as we enjoy tonight's presentations.
Welcome to 2021 Fig Arts Festival. My wife and I are so excited that once again, as we have been doing all the other years, our director of strategic ministries is bringing us once again this wonderful showcase where our people have got the chance to showcase their gifts and talents. The whole idea is to make sure that the vision of Faith in God Ministries is fulfilled. Remember, our vision is a web of church assemblies and strategic ministries engulfing the world with the gospel of the kingdom. I want you to take note of that last part, and strategic ministries. Now, these strategic ministries, the Lord really painted this vision that way so that we can give chance to people that cannot be in the mainline ministries, like apostleship, like prophets, like pastors. They may never stand on the pulpit to preach the word the way we have known it over the years. They may never have that chance, but you have a chance to do it. People have got chance. If you're called to be a singer, if you're called in the area of choirs, fine arts, solo artists, whatever it is, you are there to preach together with us. As we stand with the Bible in hand, preaching, you can stand with the same Bible in hand, preaching through music, through fine arts, whatever it is. So Faith in God Ministries, I strongly believe that in future, we will release apostles on the marketplace who are running with strategic ministries. Here is chance that you have to showcase what is inside of you. Whoever has got a gift, whoever has got something from the Lord, I want them to be supported so that we stand with them even after the festival. We actually go in, buy their wares, involve them. If they've got CDs, DVDs, we have to support by buying. God bless you.
Tupamba musimba,
have heard it for yourself from the visionary of Faith in God Ministries International, Archbishop Dr. Asa Guru Peter, where these talents and gifts are being cultivated. Now, apart from all the performances that we're going to see tonight, we are also going to be awarding individuals and groups who have been consistent in supporting this strategic ministry. We are going to call upon Lady Chido, who is going to tell us more on the structure of these awards.
Thank you so much and a warm welcome to all our guests and artists. I believe we're going to enjoy ourselves tonight. This year, our festival did not pitch any competition for our artists, reason being we are in the middle of a global pandemic, and so we are adhering to strict protocols as per COVID regulations for everyone's safety. However, we did decide to host a virtual festival, the first of its kind since its inception in 2013. We are therefore consolidating the work from 2013 to 2019 by recognizing and appreciating all those who have been consistent in running with the vision. We are therefore honoring individuals and groups in the following categories: Most Outstanding Province, Most Outstanding Pastor, Most Outstanding Group, Most Outstanding Artist, and Most Outstanding Arrow Kids Group. Recipients of these awards have shown great commitment to the tenets of the vision and have really shaped what FIG Arts Festival has become. We really appreciate them and we thank them for their support all through these past 8 years. With that being said, I say congratulations to all of them. God bless you. May you continue to run with the vision. Thank you so much.
I am an anthropological specimen of identical plumage. I perlamborate in ambitious proximity to satiate gastronomical sustainabilities in their semi-culinary departments. And I usually urge youth not to use vectorous, spectrous objects. Now, ladies and gentlemen, the question is, what did I just say? Have I just been mumbling words or being academically redundant, just being messless with words? So many people do this in life. So many people try to be so full of themselves. They try to be so sophisticated just to seem above the rest. Ladies and gentlemen, I don't mean to pontificate or to presume a higher morality, but I believe God created us to be simple. Just simple. When you look at Abraham, he was just a man looking for a son. And when he got the son, he left his inheritance to the son. I believe we're born to be simple. And the simplicity of a human being is produced by talent, the clean and clear-cut gift that God has put into you. Now, we all know, whether by knowledge or by experience, that men were born for a specific purpose. Men were born for something specific. Now, I believe, allow me to share with you what I believe we can do in order to be the specific person who lives in his purpose. I believe that as God created fish neither go for swimming lessons and birds neither go for flying lessons, but it's just in them to swim, it's just in them to fly. Now, I believe that goes for the same person or the human being, that whatever we desire or whatever we were created to do was created simply in us. We were born with a mechanism, with the mechanics to do what we want. And that little thing is called gift. If we want to do and align our lives with purpose, we should search for talent. The simple word, talent and gift.
Before we call our legends for tonight's awards, we just want to appreciate all our sponsors. We take this time to say thank you and may God richly bless you. We also want to celebrate our guest artists for tonight's show, all from AGC Doncaster. We celebrate and appreciate your efforts, Minister Pearl. And here's a sample from that stable.
take a step. I won't fear to take a step. I won't fear to move another mile forward, for I know that I am covered. I won't fear to take a step. I won't fear to take. I won't fear to move another mile forward, for I know that I am covered. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Yes, I know. Thank you.
to this. I give you all that I am. I give you all that I am. Yes, Lord, you are the King. Hey, you are, you are the King. You are the Lord. You are my God. 'Cause I will trust.
Tonight is about the artists and the amazing work that they're doing. But before we delve into more entertainment, just allow me to appreciate the wonderful ladies I'm co-hosting this show with. Guys, you are doing an amazing job to keep this show alive. Also, allow me to appreciate the organizing committee for bringing us this show. You guys, thank you very much. Now, from the City of Kings, or as some ladies would prefer, the City of Kings and Queens, hails some of the beautiful and brilliant artists to ever grace Fig Arts Festival. Hey, but don't take my word for it. Here's a look and a sample at some of the talent that is being nurtured there.
As time passes, I feel so low. Searching for peace is covering up the holes. I'll fight for your love, I'll fight for your soul. I'll throw all of my cares away for you. I'll be there to wait for you.
Mantra.
Mantra.
straight taba yena high chick. Let's go arrive at the speed. Akonsotrele Alexi le mambi sapitori banchi. Stuntman bana bana by trick. Banchu taba klela kachi. Suna man kili ten. Zwara malo. Kita koreke la maswitch.
If I die, you bury me in sand, lay me down on a bed of roses and sink me in the river at dawn. Send me away with the words of a love song. Lord, make me a rainbow. Shine down on my mother. She knows I'm safe with you when she stands under my colors. Oh well, life ain't always what you think it ought to be. No, ain't even great, but she buries her baby. The sharp knife of a shoreline. Just enough time. Oh, 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 if I die young, bury me in sand, lay me down on bed of roses.
Cries utter words of anger, anguish, pain, and sorrow. But those words are never heard because they're nothing but silent cries. Jehovah, Muzosi sees a dad. Muzosi sees a Jehovah.
My cry, feel my pain, don't let me fade away. In my cry, feel my pain, don't let me fade away.
Nothing colorful, no one cares. In saving us, no one dares. Your people are crying, dying, turning into slaves. Society turning a blind eye. It was 1918, hot stew. That Spanish flu killed every part of us. Now it's COVID-19, we can't be fighting. Come Lord, listen and help us, oh God.
Oh, listen to you, people are crying day and night. Oh, listen to you, people are crying day and night.
Mirror on the wall, tell me right now who's the greatest of them all. Hanging on the thread, yeah, that's my soul. See, here I am, I can't trust any of my own.
Hear my cry, feel my pain, don't let me fade away. Hear my cry, feel my pain, don't let me fade away. Hear my cry, feel my pain, don't let me fade away.
Turn around, I still hear the sound of these voices telling me that no matter what, I'll still be bound. See, life on earth is difficulty first, strong as granite, but time. Time exposed exfoliation to my strength, one so far for Jesus.
But feel my pain, don't let me fade.
Women exposed exfoliation to my strength,
oh God. Feel my pain, don't
here I am, oh God, say, don't let me fade, oh God. COVID-19 is taking everything away. Oh God, here we are, Lord. Look at the devil triumphing. Look at sin taking over. Churches are closed down. Everything is going haywire. Here we are, Lord, down in the situation, oh God. We come before your throne, Lord. Intervene, oh God. Because we trust no one else besides you, oh God. As you are the Ancient of Days. We go down on our knees, oh Jehovah.
I remember a time when I was on my knees, my body defiled by curses and sores. Deep within my spiritual configuration, a dismantled soul, neither broken nor sound at all. Confusion had become everything to me. It was deeply embedded within my abode. Left was right, but apparently right was also wrong. Which was which? Where was I supposed to go? But alas, it seems the wicked always have it easy, because all I've ever had to be grateful for was the fact that I'm still breathing. And with those last remarks, hope was but a turd blowing with the wind. And like dead fish, I went with the flow. Now I know that the most painful deaths are quite actually slow. My very existence had become futile. Society had deserted me. Though ironic, I smiled. But deep within my mental psyche, a duel took place. Reason pitted against morals. Conflicting thoughts flooding my mind with hatred, bred from the pearly white rose of innocence, now burning with the embers of crimson purgatory. And in an instant, I had become a devil. A devil fixated on vengeance. Vengeance for being deserted. Though deep within my heart, now void of emotions, I felt sorry for all the wrong I did. But that's dumb. You really can't expect any sympathy from a world separated by color and creed. You see, hope is all they'll ever give. Like the pendulum swing, it goes back and forth. Back and forth, no Pandora's box here. It's all crystal clear for everyone to see. But we pretend like we don't see this. We hide in the dark recesses of our mind because we only think it hurts those who live in the dark. But the truth is, we're afraid. We're afraid of accepting the dark, and we're afraid of fighting the dark. You see, fear is but the precursor to valor. But although it may seem easy to say this, it's really hard to act on. I know this for a fact because I am also a victim. But never fear, brethren, because the Lord is there for you and me. He's always there for you and me, because he is your shepherd, and he shall lead you out of the darkness. He shall walk with you in the valley of darkness. The key is patience. The key is patience.
Ladies and gentlemen, as we have promised that tonight we are going to be awarding individuals and groups that have been supporting this strategic ministry.
The Most Outstanding Province 2015 to 2020, Southern Province.
You know, many people are in the church, but they don't know who they are. So when we promote Fig Arts and we begin to locate these talented people, young people in our churches, we give them a reason to live for. We give them purpose in life, because purpose is what brings commitment. It brings discipline, focus, and integrity in life. So we are seeing that they are now focused. Most of them are now even married. They now have got their wives. They now have got marriages. They now have got children. So we really bless the name of the Lord for all that, because it would not have come if the vision of Fig Arts was not there.
Congrats. Congratulations, eagles, always flying high and gliding over circumstances. Now, the next award is being given to a man who has shown amazing sacrifice to the vision.
The Most Outstanding Pastor 2015 to 2020, District Pastor Chuma.
We were hidden, but through Fig Arts Festival, we are now too big to be hidden. And also, we appreciate that even me as a pastor, there is something that I've realized, that even the gifts, there was manifestation of gifts and talents in our churches. Some people were hidden, but because of Fig Arts, they've been availed. And also we have got some people who are not having boldness to stand in front of the church, but through Fig Arts Festival, they are now standing. They are now doing things in the church. I want to encourage every pastor in Faith in God Ministries to join in, to be part of it. It's so beneficial.
Come on right now. Everybody put your hands together.
Oh,
Sawa,
praise.
Dear Lord, I still bow to you, even when I feel finished. No matter what, I still surrender all. It doesn't matter how bad it is, because I know.
Moving on tonight, we want to take a breather and just celebrate with those awarded tonight. Help me to invite a man who is a rising star in gospel music and has recorded his album and is making hits after hit on local radio. I'm talking about none other than the king himself, Nkosi Herman Nyoni. Enjoy.
My God, you've never failed me. How should I? You go before me, you make a way. My God, how athletic. How how is your legging? my battles. You make me victorious. Nothing is too hard for you, Holy Spirit. You fight my battles. You make me victorious. Let's sing it. Nothing is too hard. Say nothing is too hard.
Yeah.
You fight my battle. Oh. Now let's sing this song for our God. Able to do the impossible, yeah.
To crown such beautiful worship, we'd like to honor the most outstanding group, Fig Arts Festival, from 2013 to 2019.
The most outstanding group, 2015 to 2020, World of Love Dance Group.
Glory to the name of the Lord!
Thank you. kuti mweya wetsvina unokuita mbembe
ukarizeya kate kani bonezi wangu Jesu katerome
nyika ino itatoka kani
bonezi wangu
Jesu kununguna muri pamuseri uko kuti nokepera kare kare
bonezi wangu Jesu
kuti nyanya itsa zvinoreva nyimya pasima sakaka yeta zvinoreva
bonezi wangu
Jesu
everybody, on behalf of World of Love Assembly Dance Group, I'd like to take this opportunity to thank Fig Arts Festival and our Father Archbishop for the powerful vision, which is arts, raising young people in the church. When we started the dance group at World of Love Assembly, the church was relatively young. We didn't have a lot of people, but we noticed a lot of young people who were just sitting in the church. And originally, we called everybody who could join the team. It was actually very big, up to even about 25, 30 people. And then, of course, had to trim it down to about 15 people. But we have seen the power and the hand of God using this team to bring up the people. I was talking to my mother the other day, and we were actually looking at the list of people that were part of the dance team. And to my surprise, about three of them are already married. Four of them are already employed, have jobs. Some of them are actually now into media in the church. Some of them are now playing instruments, and some of them are actually even now endeavoring into other forms of arts like singing, poetry. And basically everyone from that team now has something significant in their lives. And this is a big gift that Fig Arts has given unto us. I'd like to really take this opportunity to even encourage others who have not yet joined this Fig Arts Festival. It will raise up the youths in your church. It will raise up people. So once again, on behalf of World of Love Assembly Dance Group, I'd like to thank Fig Arts Festival for this award, for winning 3 years in a row. Thank you so much. God bless you.
To foster the development of gifts and talents in the church and to ensure that they shine for God in the world. It brings a sense of fulfillment among our artists. And tonight, as we continue with this virtual festival, we would like to hear some of those testimonies from our artists on how Fig Arts Festival has transformed their lives.
Hi, my name is Divine Moranger, aka Black Snow.
And my name is Amaze Moranger.
And together, we're one of the best artists you can find out there. We are digital artists that design different characters and use different elements.
And we're very passionate about what we do. And we firmly believe that this gift and passion can take us very far.
we realized that art is what attracts the young people into the house of the Lord. For us to have beautiful clothes, beautiful music that we listen to, the portraits in our homes, all that is the work of an artist, right? So in Ndebele, there is a saying that they say, "Zitiwa ngezi kudlayo." If you want to catch a fish, you use that which the fish eats, right? So if you want to catch the young people, you need to incorporate them, embrace what they love. So in that sense, art becomes very, very important because it is what attracts the young people into the church.
Ladies and gentlemen, as you can see that there is more talent that still needs to be discovered through the work of Fig Arts Festival. Now, we have some exciting news that we want to introduce you to, a new program that is heading over to Diaspora. Diaspora, you now have a chance. You better not miss it. Fig Arts Festival is now coming to Diaspora, and I am going to introduce you to the director of Fig Arts, Sir William Chingombe, who is going to tell us more on what it is.
Choice, greetings to you all, and thank you very much for tuning in to this wonderful and exciting broadcast. I believe you're having a good time as you enjoy the different performances that we have lined up for you in this first ever virtual arts festival. Now, for a very long time, almost 8 years now, we've been running this festival within Zimbabwe, and we have seen participation of a lot of church assemblies and provinces as well within Zimbabwe, where Faith in God Ministries International is headquartered. And I believe that it is now time to extend our tentacles beyond the borders of Zimbabwe, hence the launch of Fig Arts Festival Diaspora Vision. And for pastors, I would say the first thing you need to realize is that the global vision we have as Faith in God Ministries International will be achieved through twofold. One, through the activities of the church assembly, and then number two, through the programs of strategic ministries. And this is how the web of church assemblies and strategic ministries engulfing the world with the gospel of the kingdom of God will be achieved. We need a robust church assembly as well as a robust strategic ministry foundation. And this is one of it, Fig Arts Festival. It's there to identify talents and gifts that are embedded in our ministry. And those talents and gifts must be harnessed and allowed to minister as a way of propagating the gospel of Jesus Christ and also expanding the kingdom of God. So you need to identify the composition of the talent and gift that is embedded in your particular assembly, because that will speak prophetically to your mandate and your role within the global vision of Faith in God Ministries International. What I'm saying is that the composition of the talent within your assembly will speak a lot to the role that you need to play within the global vision of Faith in God Ministries International, and make sure that we achieve it together. Okay, so much about encouraging the local assemblies to participate in this great vision and make sure that they are engaged in the development of gifts and talents within their own assemblies. Now, coming to the main agenda, which is the launch of the Diaspora Fig Arts Festival. Believe you me, there is amazing talent that is out there which we need to harness, or rather, first of all, tap into it and be able to harness it so that it can shine for God. And if you don't believe me, I just want you to have a glimpse of what we have in the international church assemblies. This is South Africa, just next door neighbor to Zimbabwe, where Fig is headquartered. Just take a look at the talents that are there.
Mary, did you know that your baby boy would one day walk on water? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would save our sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you new? And this child that you deliver, he'll soon deliver you. Mary, did you know that your baby boy would give sight to a blind man?
calm the storm with his hand. Did you know that your baby boy has walked where angels trod? When you kiss your little baby, you kiss the face of God. Oh Mary, did you know?
If my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then I'll hear from heaven, I'll forgive their sin and I'll heal their land. Singing holy, 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 He's the Lord God Almighty, who was and is to come. Singing holy, 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 if my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from the wicked ways, and I'll hear from heaven, I'll forgive their sins and I'll heal their land. Singing holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, who was and is to come, singing holy, holy, holy.
So that's the first song, and I'm going to sing the second one. Since it's a short video, I have to compress the song. So the second song, here it comes.
You were pierced, you were beaten, you were crushed for me to be saved. You were pierced, you were beaten, you were crushed for me to be saved. It was by grace, it was by faith, it was by mercy for me to be saved.
And how can I help you?
I just wanted to ask, how much is the entrance fee? And I think that I have a few coins in my piggy bank.
Oh, are you ready for this, Julianne? Can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you.
It's going to be free. You don't have to pay anything.
Are
you?
Wow.
Yes. So you're going to invite your friends, hey?
I'm going to bring the whole entire world.
I can't wait. I love your spirit, Julian. See you on Saturday.
See you on Saturday.
Awesome, awesome. Caller number two, hello.
Hello, hi.
How are you? Who am I speaking to?
You're speaking to Patience Nyoni.
Patience Nyoni, how can I help you? Where are you calling us from?
I'm calling you from Gardens.
From Gardens. How is Gardens today? It's quite chilly.
Yeah, it's cold.
I can imagine. I'm sure you're warm. Make yourself a cup of tea and some ginger there.
Oh, yeah.
Great. So how can I help you? Shoot.
So where exactly in Cape Town?
Yeah, it's going to be happening at number 170 New Market Street, Woodstock, right here in Cape Town. What are you going to be doing, by the way?
I'll be singing, I'll be dancing.
Yeah. Who is your favorite artist? Can you sing for me?
I'll sing for you on Saturday.
Oh, my word. I can't wait. This is going to be a perfect surprise.
We have set up 5 critical hubs that all of us will fit in. And these hubs are not just limited to the diaspora. They also touch even the Zimbabwe church assemblies. But we are going to be giving special recognition and incentives as well to those in the diaspora so that they feel the power of participating in this great vision. The first hub we have is the performing arts. The second hub is the fine arts hub. Third hub is your film and television hub. Fourth hub is going to be having your applied arts. Fifth hub is your culinary arts hub, and it covers your food and nutrition. So these hubs are very, very critical because they are going to ensure that all the people who are gifted in our ministry will have an attachment to a particular director who will be overseeing that particular hub and be able to guide them and nurture them in the steps that they need to be taking in order for them to grow their talent. So it's very critical that you, you know, the talents that you have, you know the person who is in charge or who is manning that particular hub. So that when you come in, for instance, if you are a musician and you get attached to there are a lot of activities that will then be happening in that particular hub, which you need to follow. And these include, say, for instance, musicians, your concerts, your development programs, your exposure initiatives, whether we're going to attach you to a particular artist who will then provide mentorship programs for you. You know, all that will then be found within a specific hub. So through these hubs, we are now going to be fostering development in the following areas. Number one, we're going to create a comprehensive database of all artists in every assembly so that we may profile them for success. Number two, we're going to launch a talent magazine for the artists by artists. Number three, we're going to create international platforms for fairs, exhibitions, concerts, and festivals that will help artists realize significant value from their talent. Number four, we are going to set up a professional art school for artists to refine their talents and learn the business side of the arts. Number five, we are going to run promotional events for artists to broaden their arts horizon. Number six, we are going to establish a record label and production company that will produce and market the work of performing artists. Number seven, we are going to be involved in brand development and management for star artists. Number 8, we are going to establish an arts gallery for the artist's work on display. Number 9, we are going to be running monthly arts masterclasses in all the hubs, and these will cover different categories and genres, allowing artists to interact with experienced artists with a track record and successful artistry on the market. And number 10, we are going to attach potential artists to experienced one for mentorship programs. So there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. All these programs we have outlined are designed to make sure that the FIG Arts Festival Diaspora Vision becomes a success. And of course, the Zimbabwean church will also have an opportunity to participate in this, but we have a bias towards making sure that the diaspora participate in this particular vision. And key to all this is the networking that we are forging for all the diaspora church assemblies to be able to interact and grow the various gifts and talents within their church assemblies. With that little small talk, I want to officially launch the Diaspora Fig Arts Festival and say, this is the vision. Let it grow in your assemblies internationally, and let the international womb conceive and be able to give birth to a great and mighty seed that will impact and reclaim the mountain of arts, entertainment, and media. God bless you, and let's meet in 2022 as we explore more of this particular vision for the international church assemblies. FIG Arts Diaspora is now here. God bless you.
It's officially launched. FIG Art is now in diaspora. We thank you, and we're super excited for this invitation, and we cannot wait for 2022. Ladies and gentlemen, as you can see that this program is exceptional, and it wouldn't be if it wasn't for my co-host, Lady Kosi and Mr. Masimba. We thank you so much for making this program an outstanding one. Now we are moving on to our next award, which is the Most Outstanding Artist of the Year.
The Most Outstanding Artist 2015 to 2020, Joseph Kapitango.
See, the rhythm of praise rushes down my arteries. Its melodies escalate to my brain, leaving people thinking that I'm insane. Let me step up and dance like David and bow down like the 24 elders singing holy. Holy you are. Greetings to you all. My name is Joseph Kapitango, a 21-year-old Christian artist. I am a poet, I'm a film and theater maker, amongst all. So basically, what is poetry to me? Poetry, it's one of those art forms that speaks to the heart. And it was the first art form that I actually grasped, you know, I was actually good at, and it has made wonders in my life. It is the first art form that gave me confidence. So to me, poetry is a voice, you know, that connects to the audience, that speaks to people's hearts. Yes, so That's it. Poetry is, well, life.
Grew up as a boy, treated as a toy. From a young age, lived a life of horror. Abantu benhleka behlezi ngathi ngiyisitcom. Day and night, lived a life of fear that tomorrow will be a boogeyman. Just because there was no father to pick me up when I felt useless. I saw myself as a nobody. WrestleMania, Royal Rumble, are taking place in my cerebrum, causing me to automatically tremble as I feel that any time I might crumble. For the compression within me is giving me trouble. Success to me was inevitable. But here I am. From that time until the present, it was crying to be independent. As I locked in the cold dungeons of my soul, I can't take it anymore. I can't take it anymore. People's doctrines being washed away by the word. Somehow, somewhere, my eyes began to open, finally solved the equation, and found the devil being the square root. The tensity of the anger within me started to tear me apart, as if it was generated by the gift within. Go back to the scriptures, so that inscribed in my heart, and my discovery electrocuted me whenever I'll take my mind back. I was like a main road, everyone stepping on me, but never considered, as I always lay low, never being what I was called for. Pushed to and fro like the sand at the seashore. Like the wind, I was never seen, but thought to be present. Proverbs 18 verse 16, I believe. But the problem is, I was made the material of the roof, and they set on me because the devil told me that I can't, and I believed. Well, this is my time to arise and shine like the sun, and be in a position whereby they shall look and won't be able to touch me like the moon. And like a kite, don't give way. I go head on like a bull, sailing up high like an eagle, ready to tackle every storm, being carried up high while it's other birds high. Devil and your demons, you might be millions. Me and my guy, we might be one. Wanna see if the rule of majority works? Defeat my God and I praise you. When you see that happening, wake up. Wake up for your dreaming and belly of poop and nah. This ain't osmosis. The greater kneeling down for the lesser. But to me, you're definitely under my feet. Target me as if I'm your enemy, and see God raising me to a level of royalty. I know you think that I'm proud, but wait and see God raising me far above humanity. Haters will be hating, but like my biblical self, Joseph, they shall come back to me begging. Don't call a psychiatrist when I go crazy for the Lord. It won't be the booze that will be making me drunk when I worship. Journalist never known here. Get ready because you're about to advertise me for Mahara. They call me Simba because I'm a lion. I'm a lion living in power. I am the son of Dr. Asa and Dr. Chiza. That's why they say I am the general commander. When I say Ndiri Shumba and this is my hell, but a king ready to take over. 2018 is my year. 2018 is my land. And I, the Lord, have got many tenants ready to pay rent. And many might be annoyed, cause they're twisting it like a solenoid. But those are the things I'm trying to avoid. That's why I'm rising like the sun, and being in a position whereby they shall look and won't be able to touch me like the moon. As if I'm in a live broadcast, cameras everywhere. I'm telling the world, wait and see, as I arise as a rapper and poet for Christ. Thank you.
Wow. Congratulations to you, Joseph, a very talented young man right there, and very dedicated to his God and the God-given gift. Now, this guy has been with us from inception to date, And even on this virtual platform, he is still participating. Man, may you continue to scale greater heights with the gift that God has blessed you with. To drop more lyrical bars and hashtag positive vibes only, take a sit back and listen to this amazing music from none other than AMB.
Hallelujah. Have you ever seen me like this? Let me preach, I'm doing this with my shoes. Take a look, they don't even seem long. They fit, I wear shoe size 11. You wanna know where I'm really coming from the streets, fam. I didn't wear shoes, but I thank God I got some of my feet. I'm blessed, I know where to buy them. AMB are just my initials. I got a middle name, Dollar, is the name though. It means a great person in the present world. What you seeing really came from the name though. Wait, don't even try to diss me. I got a big foot, I know, but I like it. It was given for a reason. Besides, it was given to me fearfully. I really love my big foot. God gave me this big foot, cause I am a big man. Yeah, I mean it, I'm a big man. Listen, I don't waste, I'm the Antichrist. I'm alive today, it's a miracle. Shoe size should be big enough to step on every step, and we just put on earth by God himself. Well, I will plan it like a funeral. I'm doing for Christ, this end for me. Why did you run the foot? They should be running for me. Most of my people don't even speak. I'm winning souls all over the world. Bring them to cycles, disciple cycles, making disciples inside the cycles. I'm in a cycle, Shanity cycle. God bless the cycles. Hallelujah. Even if the devil tried to come in COVID-19, I'm not afraid because I got my big footy. Get me some shoes and to see what I do to it. Any disaster in my way, I will step in. The world we are living really seem like boxing ring. The fight we are fighting the devil is not to lose. Gotta punch your back, play every day till you're busting. I thank God for some shoes. I ain't giving you shoes size 11. Would you tell you now? I just wanna feel say shoes size 11. I can't hear you. Yeah, I'm stepping in shoes size 11. Yeah, shoes size 11. Shoes size 11. Shoe size 11. Yeah.
In line with the objective of catching them young, ladies and gentlemen, help me to honor and to present our final award of the night to the most outstanding Arrow Kids of Faith in God Ministries International.
The most outstanding Arrow Kids group, Highfields Dance Group.
Evangelizing through arts. As you can see in iFood, all people are gathered around watching. As they gather, we catch them young. We want to catch them young because, you know, young generation of today, they like dancing. So we are bringing them to Christ through dancing. This is what we are doing. So we are encouraging everyone, say, let's move with the vision and let's catch the vision and catch them young. Thank you very much.
What a ball of energy from these youngsters. They are set out to become more relevant in the church than outside. It's an amazing strategy to catch them young and make sure that they maintain a DNA of a God-fearing generation. Ladies and gentlemen, tonight has been more than amazing.
Indeed, Kosi, and thank you very much for keeping the bar up throughout tonight's show. I enjoyed every single bit of it.
Just like James, Peter, and John on the mountain of transfiguration, I would say, let us build our tents and stay here and enjoy this show. But we have an assignment to do. Ladies and gentlemen, help me to thank and to congratulate all the performers and award winners of tonight. Thank you for making us who we are as Fig Arts Festival.
Indeed, Minister Pell, we are very grateful for everybody who's tuned in with us tonight. And for my people in the comment section, thank you for those fantastic comments. We really appreciate it. We can only go up, and up we are going.
Yes, we meet at the top. And to our partners and our sponsors, thank you so much for making this happen. To our amazing organizing committee, till we meet again in September 2022 for another amazing Fig Arts Festival show, this time with the diaspora participation.
I'm so excited. I'm super, super, super excited. The time we've been waiting for has arrived. Fig Arts Festival. One thing that makes me so excited is that the festival is now crossing the borders, dubbed Fig Arts Festival Diaspora. My region, Western Cape Province, Dubai, United States of America, Fiji, Australia, New Zealand, we are coming full force to participate. See you there.
So we've seen the power of the arts, particularly in our region. And I do believe and strongly believe from the deepest part of my heart that the launch of Diaspora Fig Arts Festival not only gives us the opportunity to participate in the vision, but it also allows us to impact generations as we give people the opportunity and the freedom to savor in the uniqueness of their gifts. So with that being said, Fig Dallas, Texas in the United States of America, we are more than ready.
We as Fig Zambia, we are very excited about the idea of launching Fig Diaspora Arts Festival. We believe in this a great initiative that will help us minister to different various social groups. In the process, usher our children into entertainment industry. In the process also, we'll see us participating in the vision of the church. We are so excited.
Desde la Ciudad de México, hola hermanos, me alegra de que Fig Arts se celebre en todos los países donde está nuestra iglesia. Estoy feliz de abrazar esta visión y correr con ella para la gloria de Dios y la extensión de su reino.
South Africa is the most vibrant arts and entertainment industry in Africa, and the launch of the Diaspora Fig Arts Festival gives us an opportunity to cater the young and the old who are inspired by the arts. We're excited by this initiative. See you there.
Hi there, I'm Deaconess Tutsi Webb from Botswana. We are in a season where the arts and the entertainment industry are shaping people's lives. End of the arts. The launch of the Diaspora Fig Arts Festival is coming to town and we are so excited. This gives us a great opportunity to positively impact this generation. We are ready to dive into this vision and make it happen.
Hello, hello, hello. Wherever you are, worldwide, I am Pastor Moses Mbringai. Right in the warm heart of Africa, Malawi, we are overwhelmed to participate in Fig Art Festival 2022. We are there.
2022, you better look out because Diaspora, we are coming. Finally, we have come to the end of our program tonight. We thank you so much for tuning in. It's been a pleasure hosting you. I am Minister Pearl from AGC Doncaster. We leave you in a celebratory mood with one of our guest artists, Calvin Oscar of AGC Doncaster. We love you, but God loves you more. From us to you.
Jesu makanaka taziona atina kutirwa isu tazionera tati Jesu makanaka taziona atina Isu tazionera toimba Jesu
Jesu makanaka
oh makanaka baba
tazionera
atina
atina kutirwa
oh tazionera
tazionera
toimba Jesu Andina kutirwa Ine tazionera Munyika yakaoma kudai baba Tinongokunda nenyasha dzenyu Jesu Andina kutirwa Isu tazionera Toimba Jesu
Jesu
Mane mimwe amutwene
Ndoswa ndinoda
Irimo muvepoe
Ndoswa ndinoda
Mane mimwe amutwene
Ndoswa ndinoda